I'm actually a little puzzled by the focus on that particular provision. There are many provisions, you know, that you could look at. Glass-Steagall, of course, is the rule, the 1930s era rule that separates commercial banking, lending, deposit taking from investment banking, underwriting securities and the like, and that was repealed in the 90s. I think that if you look at the actual, you know, what happened a few years ago in the crisis, that Glass-Steagall was pretty irrelevant to it because you had banks like Wachovia or WaMu that went bad because they made bad loans, and you had investment banks like Bear Stearns and Lehman that went bad because of their investment banking activities, and Glass-Steagall could have been in place. It would have had no effect on most of these firms. AIG would not have been unaffected by Glass-Steagall. I think the only major financial institution that Glass-Steagall would have a major effect on is probably Citi, which still has some of the supermarket elements. But for the most part, you know, I think it would just be an example of breaking up firms for the purpose of breaking them up without a clear rationale for doing that. I think there are other ways to simplify banks that would be more effective.
Yeah.
You know, while it may not be fully appreciated that a lot of what Dodd-Frank did and some of the other international agreements have moved us in a direction where we are moving towards, you know, a situation where banks are now evaluating their own size and complexity in light of the fact that, on the one hand, there are economic benefits to size, but on the other hand, it's becoming much tougher to be a big bank. You put the incentives in the right place and force banks to think about, you know, whether their size and complexity is justified in an economic sense, or whether it's basically, you know, can be dispensed with and you can get simpler banks. I think over time the pressure will be on banks to simplify. Yeah. The most important tool, and I need to say, is the liquidation authority that Dodd-Frank created, which allows the Fed and the FDIC to unwind firms after the fact, but also before the fact, to require them to simplify in ways that they could be unwound. Breaking them into tiny little pieces, you know, you're going to lose a lot of value if you do that without thinking about, you know, what the economics is.